how to create all kinds of wonderful curved designs in Affinity Photo, PC or Mac. In Affinity Photo, go to the Tools panel and select the Pen tool. Click the document and add a line. Hold down the Shift key to make it 45 degrees. Also, you can go up here, set the stroke colour. It can be anything, it can be black, green, blue, but also you can set 2 points as well as using pressure. So you can change the pressure to modify the line. But also what you can do, you can go to the layer and here go down to duplicate linked. That creates a special kind of linked line. Any change to one will be changing all the others. Now, if you're using 2.2, you can go here with the move tool. You can now press return or enter on the keyboard. With that horizontal, you can change the settings. So I'm just going to go for a bit of about 25 pixels. Now, if you haven't got 2.2, you can still do this, but just you need to duplicate it normally. Just hold down the Alt or Option key and drag to duplicate the lines. But this is a really much quicker way of doing it. You can then go to Duplicate and Number of Copies. And I'm going to go for, say, 50 or 60. And this is what I mean. It's quicker to do this with this new feature. And click OK. And you can see now you've got all these curves. Now, all of them are linked. So if you want to, just go here, go to the Node tool. And with the Node tool, you can then just drag. And you can just distort this, move this around in all kinds of ways, and they all change. You can also click on it and then add another curve. You've got there, the point there. Click again, add another curve, and so on. All kinds of different curves. And if you're unhappy with the curve, just undo. Don't have to keep it. You can always go back and change it and tweak it again and again. Again, undo, and you go back. And you've just got the original line. And you can just change that until you're happy with your curve. You can also select all of the curves, right-click, and then group. Just makes it easy to manipulate. And you can manipulate it in many different ways. You can resize it like that. Now, you can also use it as a great source for a pattern design. But to do this, what you need to do, you need to convert it into a raster layer. So layer, pixel. So layer and rasterize if you want to do that. Now I'm going to do that anyway, because I want to go into the next step, which is rasterize. And now I'm going to deform it. Now, if you don't want to go that, you could just keep it as curves. Perfectly reasonable. Maybe save it to the assets panel. Use it in future work. Then go to filters and you go to distort, deform. Also use mesh warp. That's a great one. All these other ones are excellent as well, but deform. And I'm just going to go for similarity. So similarity. And I'm just going to add some pins and I'm going to distort it. And you can see as I distort this line, you can see it creates all kinds of different designs. Now, once you've created it, you might think, wow, that's a great bit of interest in a certain particular area. So I'm just going to go maybe click apply. Now, I don't want the entire design because I want to turn this into a pattern. Now, this design is not great for turning into a pattern. But if you go for a particular area, you might think, that looks the best. Don't like this part. It's got a bit of distortion that's not doesn't look good. But I'm happy with that. And with that, I can now turn that design into a pattern. So layer, new pattern layer from selection. And you can see the result of that. Now I could have selected anywhere else as well. And I'm just removing the previous one. So here's this pattern layer. Go to the move tool and I want this to be mirrored. So I got this mirrored, and now when I can do that, I can resize this, rotate it, but also I can hold down the Alt or Option key because it's a layer, and I can duplicate it. And you can see then I can combine these two layers to create all kinds of truly abstract, weird and wonderful line designs using this approach. You can also select both of them and then go to Layer and Merge Selected. Sometimes the result is slightly different. And again, you can resize it, rotate it, as well as apply additional filters as well. Filters can be applied to this, so filters, distort, and deform, or maybe go for mirror and apply a mirror effect. And you can see then, create that, number of mirrors, and you can create all kinds of truly weird and wonderful black and white designs, all based on that single straight line you had at the start. And click apply. You can also use the lines to overlay any image. Now I've got an image here, Adobe stock image. What you can do, filters, go to blur and Gaussian blur, just blurring the image. So I just want that to be nicely blurred and click apply. Now you can push it to 200, 300, but you can go back to the lines, and with the lines, hold down the alter option key and you can drag. So you can drag that group and then create some lines over on top of that original image. And of course you might have to do it again and drag, and you can position them anywhere. You don't have to have them exactly equal. They don't have to be. You could have maybe gaps in it, perfectly reasonable, but you can just place it there, and there you've got a lovely unusual line design across your image. You can also select all of them and then group those as well. So group, and so right click and group all the groups, and then just duplicate that. So layer and duplicate. So the group is now duplicated, and then you can apply a transform to it. So with the layer selected, right click and then go to transform, and then flip horizontal, say. And then you've got that sort of unusual grid design on top of your image. If you've got any questions, please let me know in the comments below. A like or dislike, always appreciated. Thank you much.